Guerrero is the youngest, is one of the youngest to ever play. He is the one of two to ever be in the Home Run Derby. Let me check how many home runs Vlad Guerrero has. I don't think he has that many. But he only has 8 in only 52 games, which isn't great, but when you're the Home Run Derby isn't a hot commodity to play in. There's a reason a lot of sluggers don't play in it. Bellinger did say he might be playing next year when it comes to Los Angeles. One name I am surprised to be seeing here is Christian Yelich. He's not your typical home run hitter. However, he does have a lot of power, and I can understand why he wants to be in the hitting in the All-Star game. In the Home Run Derby. Okay. So the last topic I'm going to talk about, as we have about a little less than 10 minutes left in the show, no, a little more than 10 minutes left in the show, is Jake Lamb. I did mention him in the mailbag questions, as one of the comments on Reddit had mentioned. How do we use Jake Lamb? And Jake Lamb is a he. 2017, he had a breakout year and did really well, and then he ended up on the injured list. And in 2018, he was not the same player, and then he's been injured in the last 3 seasons. But I could definitely see him being a platoon against righties. However, with the way Walker has been playing, I don't see how you can, in your right mind, bench him if you're Torey Lovello. However, Lovello would start 9 catchers if he could. But so you're just gonna look up some Jake Lamb splits for him based on lefty versus righty. He's an interesting player. You'd think he would be more consistent against both. This season, his WAR is -0.1 in 24 at bats, and he has 5 hits, 3 RBIs. So, not a lot of at bats you have there, but. Yeah, so I'm gonna look at his last basically full year, which was 2017, in which he played 149 games. Last year he only played in 56, so it's not a lot there for you to base him off of. I can't seem to find where it says his where it says lefty versus righty batting average and hits and stuff like that. While I'm trying to find those things, I'm just gonna mention that. He is also a he Alex Avila did make it back from the injured list along with Jake Lamb in this past week. So two players coming back. And so yeah, hopefully he can contribute and just overall be a good player. It doesn't seem to say how many, how he has been. I can't find it anywhere. Lefty versus righty. I just do know that he is worse against lefties, as he does hit lefty. And I could also see the main reason I could see him being kept on is that if it is late situation, they can do a double switch with him. He can play third and first, and he's played a good share of
He hasn't played a lot of first in his career, but he does have Goldie's old glove, and I could see him being a okay, wait, I found it. Okay. So versus right-handed batters, he had 404 at bats, 479 plate appearances, in which he hit 282. In 156 plate appearances and 132 at bats against left-handed pitchers, he hit 144. So really bad stats there, but overall, he's better against lefty starters than lefty relievers, I guess. But he's just not very good against lefties, and I don't see why you would choose to have him play when you could have when you could have Christian Walker, who has been doing really strong recently, surprisingly, and I definitely like Jake Lamb. He's a good player. He can play at different places. I could see him platooning, not platooning with Escobar, but filling in if need be, if someone's hurt or sore or just need a break in the long schedule. I definitely think his time as a starter are over until Escobar leaves or Walker leaves. But it is tough to see, as he did go from playing third to losing that spot, and then losing his spot over at first after getting injured, and Christian Walker just really doing well. So, not a lot you can do if you're Jake Lamb other than prove your worth playing, which I don't think he will be doing soon. I hope he can, but Jake Lamb's definitely one of the fan favorite players. And I'm also going to mention something about the Diamondbacks bullpen and TJ McFarland, who he has been terrible this year. I don't think he has too much experience this year or overall, but he did get injured this season and did miss a lot of the season. So this season, his WAR is negative 0.8 and his ERA is 6.28. So, in 17 games, in 28 innings, not good. He doesn't get a lot of strikeouts. He averages 1.5 hits, more than 1.5 hits a game, an inning, which definitely isn't good when you're a relief pitcher and these guys are seeing you for the first time in the game, and they should be struggling sort of to hit off of you. However, I guess that's not what happens when you're a Diamondbacks relief pitcher. Just some more stats for this season. He's given up 35 hits and 22 runs in 28 innings. Three home runs. He's issued 11 walks, only 18 strikeouts, and hit one batter. In 20, he's never really done well overall. His lowest ERA ever is 2 in 47 games with the Diamondbacks last year. And then other than that, it's 2.76 in 2014 with the Orioles. He is also an older player. He's 30 years old already, which isn't old, but definitely not when you want to already be regressing to a guy that has an ERA in the sixes. I definitely can see the Diamondbacks going for some bullpen help. Maybe it's something that can make it so that they can contend and they can still put up a fight against the rest of their really strong division. Or they can, of course, trade people if need be. I wouldn't like to see anybody traded except maybe some of our bullpen guys like TJ McFarland or Archie Bradley, considering they've been struggling heavily. But I really don't want to see Greinke go. It would be hard to see him leave, considering he's Zach Greinke. He says some great stuff, and he's just overall a pretty funny guy. And I think he's worth the money that we've been paying him so far. He's definitely been playing like the ace we expect him to. And with that, I'm gonna be wrapping it up. So thanks for tuning in to the Diamondbacks Rattle Up podcast. I'll be back next Sunday, which is not exactly sure what date next Sunday is. It's the 7th. So yeah, make sure you join me next Sunday, the 7th, July 7th. This is the last one of June. Follow me on Twitter at csumner710, and make sure you follow me on Instagram at chris_sumner710. Yeah, so thanks for listening, and make sure you tune in next time. Thank you, and talk to you guys. See you later.